Hallelujah. It's only if God has not turned your life around. That's when you stand like a statue. Attention. Has God turned anything in your life? You need to thank him because he's the one turning things. There is no assistant doer. We only have one doer. There is no deputy doer. There is only one doer. We are going to say, Lord, for all you have done for us this month, which we know that you are still doing, we thank you. Lift up your voice and appreciate him. Give him praise. We remain grateful for all of your blessings, for all of your favors, all your interventions, all of your mercies, all of your help. You are the way maker, the story changer, the glory and the lifter of our head. We give you all the praise. You have turned our lives around. You have confirmed your word. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Your suffering is coming to a permanent end today. Whatever is behind financial shame in your life, today it will end permanently. Make that amen like a believer. Any power that is behind struggle in your life, today they will let you go by force. I said they will let you go by force. In the name of Jesus Christ, so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Make that amen louder. Amen. Tell your neighbor, congratulations for making it to this service. Put your hands together for the Lord and please take a seat. In this financial fortune banquet service, the power behind misfortune in your life will be broken permanently today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Like you heard in the announcement, this Monday, we are going to kick off our specialized prayer session, disgracing the strong man against the fulfillment of your destiny. Anyone that is not going forward, there's one strong man somewhere that has vowed to keep him bound. But hear me, their era over your life is over. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. So take advantage of that Monday prayer. And also on Friday, engaging the angels. Hear me, every breakthrough that takes place, angels are involved. You are not just the doer. There are some battles you won't know how they were won. You won't know how they were won, but they fought for you. They fought for you. But they can't fight if you didn't provoke them into action. So, that Friday prayer, see it as an opportunity to enter the next phase again. And also Saturday, 6 a.m. That 6 a.m. prayer is targeted solely for family. Are you hear what I'm saying? God's interest is in families. Everything that is moving the church forward is from family that it springs up. If your family is blessed, another family is blessed, there will be commotion in the church. Because everybody wants to be like your family. So that's 1 hour prayer. Very crucial. Take advantage of it. And I see God doing new things in your life and family in Jesus' name. Amen. This second service, our focus is sacrificing for your financial dreams and fortune. In third service, we are going to look at the power of sacrifice. But this side, we are looking at you sacrificing for your financial dreams and fortune. Don't forget, any faith that makes God absolutely responsible is an irresponsible faith. It's an irresponsible faith. And I will say it again. I echo it. In fact, we echo it to ourselves, me and my wife. Papa said, you are absolutely responsible for the outcome of your total destiny. All this one, God will do it, God will do it. Be waiting for when God will do it. God looks at what you do to determine his input. If you are doing nothing, expect nothing from God. Sacrificing your financial dream for your financial dreams and fortunes. Every future is determined by sacrifice. Every great future is determined by sacrifice. So the sacrifice I give, the sacrifice you give, determines the levels of financial fortune I'm permitted to see. If I sacrifice little, I will experience little. If I'm casual about my sacrifice, God also will be casual about what comes to me. So the level of every man's financial fortune is tiered up by the sacrifice he's willing to give. A person you see enjoying a level of financial fortune now committed himself to a measure of sacrifice. So our sacrifice level varies from one person to another. Why? Because we are seeing differently. We are not all seeing the same thing. Many are looking, few are seeing. Everybody is looking. Not everybody is seeing. Even God himself is particular about what you see. No wonder I told Abraham, what seest thou? So, if I'm sacrificing more, it's because I've seen more. The brighter you see, the brighter you go. It's a shame that in church, people are so careless about their financial destiny. Because they are holding God absolutely responsible for everything that will come to pass. God will do it. Except he wants him to take you back to the days of the wilderness where he was throwing manna from heaven. No, there's no manna from heaven now. Are you hearing me now? But I will tell you, the manna that is available is in third service. Financial misfortune can end if you are willing to pay your price. I've discovered when people are tired for their suffering, they desire a change. When people are fed up with their hardship, they look for something meaningful to do. When people are no longer willing to cope with their torture that they are going through, something will be telling you in your heart, there is a way out. There is a way out. There is a way out. Scripture says he makes a way where there seems to be no way. There is a way out. And like I said in the course of the beginning, until you do your part, God will not play his part. Until man's part is guaranteed, God's hand will not be seen. What does the sacrifice involve to see my financial dreams turn around? Number one, studio, I beg, do me a favor, make sure this message is recorded properly. Number one, dedicate yourself to a lifetime of learning. To a lifetime of learning. Proverbs chapter 1 and verse 5, a wise man will hear and increase in learning. A man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsel. Your learning determines your earnings. If you learn well, you will earn well. Quality learning will bring about quality earning. We don't all earn the same. We earn differently because we know differently. That's why what you know now gives you an edge. That's why they call it knowledge. Divide it into two. You know you have an edge. What I know more that you don't know gives me an edge over you. What I know now and take advantage of, you may not take advantage of it because you may see it as a trap. You may see it as something that, no. It's not conventional. It must not be conventional. If you learn more, you will earn more. And one thing I've known, learning brings about discovery. Every time you learn, you discover what others have not seen. And if you see what others have not seen, you will get what others can't get. If you see what others cannot see, you will get what others can't get. Because you are the one that see it. You saw it first, so you take advantage of it. And since your eyes have not been opened to it, you may see it and say, no, this is not the kind of, this is not conventional business. You hear me? Business is changing with technology. Am I correct? So if you are saying, this is not how we learned it, as it was in the beginning, it's now, so shall it be, forever and ever, na lie. Be dedicated to learning. Even our father, Bishop Oyedepo, he said something last week. He said the time for the church to engage in high-level technology to go digital in handling some affairs of the church is now, because we cannot use obsolete method to handle new levels growth. New levels growth. The growth now is high level. So you can't be doing... Now, if you are accounting and you are doing ASDF, you don't finish. Your work don't finish. Because even the accounting of these days now have entered SAGE. And you know SAGE is in levels. Say bookkeeping. Thank God for bookkeeping. So you need to improve in your learning. The more you improve your learning capacity, the more you enlarge your earning capacity. Your capacity for earning is enlarged as you improve your learning. And you know, learning goes with a price. It doesn't just come. There is a price you must pay to sit down to know what you have not known before. And that's where the real problem is. Everybody's looking for fast money. Hear me. Breakthrough, get work. There is no breakthrough that does not go with work. You must learn the process, learn the procedure, learn what makes it to be sustained. Learn it. One of my leader in one of the investments that we are doing forwarded me a video of an 11-year-old Indian who is based in Canada, currently earning $1.25 million from Google. So they now ask him, are you not going to school? He says he's going to school from home. That is not a disadvantage. That is, if you are seeing it as a disadvantage, it's only in your mind. 11 years. If you want the video, come, I will forward it to you. So that you listen. If you listen to him talk on technology, you'll be wondering, then born I'm inside the team. No. He has been following the process. He has been getting used to the language. He said he has written one book that is writing another one. How can 11-year-old is already in the process of developing softwares? Hear me? If you fail to learn, you will be a poor man. Even with the weight of prophecies being released every day. Thank God, he said in his word, it is all that teacheth thee, not prophesy. Prophecy sets the heavens open. Teaching puts to practice. So you must give yourself to learning. Learning. Buy books. Learn. Papa said, and I quote, "I teach you prosperity once in a year. You go and learn and discover the others by yourself." I'm not afraid to say it. Go and learn it. It's not tie and coat that pays. You must sit down to do what? Learn. By learning, you become innovative. By learning, you become creative. When you interact with learners, you will be motivated. As iron sharpeneth iron, so does a man sharpen the countenance of his friend. If you are hanging around anyone that is not sharpening you, you will become blunt very soon. Blunt, damaged. Hang around learners and you will improve. Hang around non-learners and you'll be damaged. You must give yourself to learning. Paul said, give yourself to reading. Number two, what does the sacrifice involve? Don't forget we are talking about sacrificing for your financial dreams and fortune. Number two, be committed to making it work. The worth of anything is what someone is willing to pay the price. The worth of anything is what anyone is willing to do what? Pay the price. So it is price that determines what. What I mean by what? I mean value. You can't get the most out of anything. You can't get the best out of anything with less effort. You must put in more effort. You must do what? Put in more effort. You must put in more effort. The effort you put is reflected in your passion. I've discovered it is passion that fuels commitment. I'm committed to knowing this thing because I want it to pay me. I want it to pay me. If it must pay me and pay me well, then I must give it extra commitment. What you call extraordinary is just extra. If you remove the extra, it is ordinary. It is common. It is the same. I won't forget an incident that took place. Was it last month? Yes, it's last month. When my SEC chairman, who is happened to be the CBN controller, said that he wants me to talk in that blockchain and cryptocurrency, this thing, in the Just Center. He wants me to talk. I said, how many minutes? He said, 10 minutes is enough. 10 minutes? I said, I can't talk on blockchain for 10 minutes. He said, anyway, that we just want you to talk for 10 minutes. We'll give other people opportunity to talk. So I told my boy, bring my slides. I said, put this one, put this one, put this one, put this one. A presentation that will take place minimum 130 minutes was summarized in 10 minutes. All I need to do, pick the points. By the time I finish talking, please, can we have your phone number? Can we have your phone number? Can we have your phone number? Why? Detail study. I said, but you say you are pastor. I say, yes, I'm pastor. I'm pastor. Full time, not part time. Do you know why? Making money does not respect title. Financial demand does not know your title. When need come, give me. It's not asking you, you'll be pastor. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? So after the presentation, his leader was asking him, find out from that man, it's like he has something that... I said, no, I just developed myself to knowing it better because that's where the world is going. So let me pay my price now and secure my lot. Anything you are not committed to cannot pay you. It can't pay you. So if you want more, be willing to do more. Be willing to do what? Anything you are doing. If you are frying akara, if you are doing granite, be willing to do more. You must think, what do I need to do to create more outlets? To pay me more? Because your needs are not growing less, they are growing big. Be willing to do more. I've discovered that majority are looking for parts with less resistance. You will not find one. There is no path that leads to glory that does not have opposition and obstacles, that does not have challenges. I won't forget one of our members. He worships in Canaan land. How many of us have heard of the name Stephen Akintayo? Nobody. He met me last year. After 21-day fasting, he said, Pastor, if you want to take this thing to the next level, you need to go digital. I said, what will it cost me? He said, $2 million. I said, bro. Shey, he said, you'll be pastor. He said, Pastor, I don't play with my business. You either pay or you go. I thought he was joking. After I dropped my children in school, after the 21-day fasting, I now went to meet him in the house. I said, hey, that thing we were talking about, I said, are you ready? It's cash down before we start. I said, so you mean that? So he said, I have to make $1 million down payment before they will start. He said, by the time we are through with you, all you just need to do is just sit down in your house and you'll be getting a lot. Bok up, bok up, bok up, bok up. But in the process, he was driving me towards excellence. Why? Commitment brings about improve in quality. If you want, okay, let me use this very simple example. I think it will catch all of us now. Who has eaten mama put here before? If you say never eat mama put, you are a winch. Now, there is nothing mama put is doing that you go to Mr. Biggs or Sizzlers or Tantalizer are doing differently. The only thing is that they did packaging. Tell your neighbor packaging. So you are only paying extra money for the package. There is nothing special. If our mama puts on, it's even sweeter. Am I correct? But because they repackaged it, you pay higher money. Am I saying the truth? Tell your neighbor, it's time to repackage. When you repackage, you give yourself a brand. If you want to see quality fortune, give yourself proper packaging. No wonder Toyota, they say, good thinking. Good thinking. As you are improving on your thinking, you are improving on the quality of your what? Product. If they tell you now that you will buy phone for 300,000, will you agree before? Say the truth. Say the truth. Will you agree? Say, for what? Me buy phone 300,000 for what? But the phone they are selling 300,000 now is a machine. Three of us. Inside that phone, there is a scanner. Am I correct? Inside that phone, everything is inside. What they did, they upgraded what we saw 15 years back. They improved in the quality so that we can pay higher money. Am I saying the truth? So if you are not ready to improve your quality, if you are not committed to upgrading, hear me, you will go for lesser money. Bigger fortunes go for people with higher quality. Number three, what does the sacrifice involve? I call it engaging the law of delayed gratification. I'll be detailed. Don't be so much in a hurry to make it. We are not, all fingers are not equal. You are not doing competition with anybody. Life is in phases. Men are in sizes. The future is waiting for everybody. We are coming in style. Now, what does delayed gratification say? Know your wants and know your needs. Your needs are different from your wants. I want it is different from I need it. There are so many things we are rushing in for now, we don't need it. If you have added it to what you are doing to your business, it will have helped you to grow better. It is only in this age and in the church where you see someone that does not have a job, is not doing something tangible, buying phone of 100,000. I remember one young man came one day. He said he was looking for welfare. So God just caught him that day. He was looking for welfare, and I can tell the price of his phone. I said, oh boy, you don't need welfare. He said, Pastor, I tell you the truth. I said, go sell your phone. The money you dey look for, they inside your phone. You have not reached the level of handling such phones. Many of them are holding big phones. It's just for WhatsApp and Facebook. If you have money to be buying bundle, man, you get money to start. Delayed gratification say, wait. Compound and arrive. Some people, they are in business, they are eating down the business. Others are pushing back. Now, I went for a training with my family in Johannesburg in December. So, in the process, I asked Hannah, who happened to be the number one in Beat Club, how did you arrive at this level? She said, I have up to so and so accounts. So you are making this. But she didn't want to tell me the truth. She didn't want to tell me. So, and I came back out of curiosity and intense reasoning. I found out that in my shelf, I have this book tagged 80-20 rule. How many of us have seen that book? If you see it, buy it. It's not for fancy. 80-20 rule. So I read the book to a point. I said to myself, no, I've got it. I've got it. I've got it. So I said, okay. So instead of drawing from my profit, I push it back. I push it back. I push it back. I push it back. It will get to a point, if I want to draw now, it will be like elephant shit. So I called her one day and say, Anna, I've got your secret, but I will not tell you. Why? Because I discovered it with better light. 80-20 rule is what brings about what we call compound interest. If you are in business now and you want your business to pay you well, stop feeding fat on your profits. If not, your business will soon die quick. Many of us don't know. This ministry is applying that principle. Way back 2004, Papa suddenly changed. Spend 30, send back 70. So some people started getting angry. No, these are tough. But now, the ministry can start 100 projects at the same time without raising offering in 100 stations. What did they do? They consolidated on their reserve by reason of the practice. Spend 30, saves 70. If you want to live in a lifetime of fortune, you must apply the law of delayed gratification. It's a compulsory law. For anyone that wants to remain ever flourishing in business, the law of delayed gratification. I remember one time, some of my colleagues, they were yabbing me. Go and buy better phone. We know you can buy it. Go and buy better phone. I looked at one face to face. Is the phone biting you? I'm not doing competition with anybody. Everybody is running his race. So you decide how you will arrive and when you will arrive. True of us. So when you apply the law of delayed gratification, you kill competition. We are not doing competition. You are not seeing what I'm seeing, so you can't do what I'm doing. You buy shoe, I buy shoe. I know they for that game. You buy car, I buy car. I know they for that rubbish. I can choose to buy car anytime I want. But there is where I'm targeted. So let me use the law of delay gratification and compound so that when I do, bah, they say, hey, when it starts, you wouldn't know when I've been applying that law. I've been applying that law since. I may be doing like this. You are doing like this. I may be doing like this. I'm coming small, though. But you wouldn't know what I'm doing. I'm coming. Before you know what's happening, I will reach where you reach. Even bigger and better. Check the wise. They invest more and spend less. Why? The law of delayed gratification. Number four is what I call the power of investment. Making money is good. Everybody's making money. But not everybody's investing. There is no... Let me just put it this way. 80% of the persons here now are making money. But not everybody is investing. People that are making money are used to what we call hand to mouth. But people that are making investment, they are thinking of securing the tomorrow. Having an edge for the tomorrow. If you are not an investor, you will still be a beggar. Opportunities are designed to help us change level, not to increase difficulties. One opportunity is an open door. I call it the dynamics of opportunity. It creates an interface between now and tomorrow. If you don't take advantage of it, you will just suddenly discover that you are still on the same spot. But that does not mean that you are not getting opportunity. You are getting opportunity, but your head is not correct. Because you are only thinking of now, you are not thinking of securing tomorrow. Tomorrow's game can never be like today's game. But to make tomorrow dance to your tune, you need to take advantage of the opportunity you have now and push forward for tomorrow. That's where investing comes. Investment in power is powerful. The truly rich, the truly wealthy, they are thinking of investing. When money enters your hand, what do you think of first? The poor man thinks of what he will buy now. The poor man thinks of vacation now. That's why any person I hear that I say is a contractor is in trouble. I will sit him down to repackage his head. Do you know why? Some contractors don't think straight. Making money is not once in a while. Because your needs don't come once in a while. They come every day. Some of them, when they make one contract, they go and sit down and begin another prayer or fasting. Your head is not correct. He gives seed to the sower and bread to the eater. If you are thinking well, something has entered your hand. Look for another opportunity. Contracts don't come every month. Does it come every month? When money enters a poor man's hand, the first thing he thinks of, the next shirt to buy, the next car to buy, the next vacation to go. Vacation need to finish. But when money enters into a rich man's hand, he has been calculating an opportunity to enter. He has been calculating. That's why, by my discovery, money has an ecosystem. It's part of my book, Financial Intelligence. Money has an ecosystem. What do we call an ecosystem? Thank God all of you here do biology. Now, what we call an ecosystem, you're already making profit from this. You spot another opportunity. You don't need to look for another money. You take from this, you enter this. You take from this, you enter this. This one is still yielding. This one has started yielding. Another one is started yielding. Now, you have sorted another one. You enter another one. That's an ecosystem. You can never get to a point where you are money dry. That's what investors do. If you want to find yourself in the cycle of continuous harvest, hear me, you must also operate the cycle of continuous investment. So, to do this, you must invest time, invest knowledge, resources. Thank God we started with learning, because what learning will do for you is to help you spot goodly opportunities. When you spot it, man, you are God. Good. Just keep walking. If you are continuously broke, it's not God's fault, it's your fault. If you are continuously broke, you see opportunity and call it mechanic uniform. That's the truth. And lastly, what does the sacrifice involve? This sacrifice will involve what we call the law of association, which is also scriptural. He that walks with the wise shall be wise. A companion of fools shall be what? Destroyed. Mike Mudo calls it the golden rule of success. Successful people, they succeed in the circle of their influence, in the circle of their friends. If the people you are hanging around with are not influencing you positively, financially, think well and decamp. I've discovered also, people with quality money hang around quality company. The quality of your company will determine the quality of your money. Hanging around gossipers. How much have you sold in your gossiping? How much have you sold? How much profit has entered your hand? You know, gossiping has gone high tech now. We have WhatsApp gossiping. It's no longer a midnight call. The moment they WhatsApp you, it can go viral. They can viral your gossip inside church. And they'll be telling you, bless you, sir. Bless you, sir. My case is different. How much has your gossiping produced? I've discovered real businessmen don't hang around gossipers. They have enough consuming their time not to listen to nonsense talkers. The people you are hanging around today will increase your poverty the next 5 years, or they will increase your wealth the next 5 years. Write it down. I said so. So your company determines what accompanies you. The moment you begin to associate with people that help to upgrade you and improve you, man, I tell you the truth, you are on another platform. There may not be money in your pocket now, but they have helped to change your perspective. And because they have helped to change your perspective, I bet you, where you see will determine where you reach. Where you see will determine where you reach. If you are not seeing well, someone is helping you not to see well. And if you are truly seeing well, someone is helping you to see well. Someone is helping you to see well. Permit me to say this. There are some friendships you need to sacrifice. I don't tire for you. Since I've been hanging around you, my life never improved. But you know what? If I leave now, how will she feel? How will he feel? Remain there. Your family will eat poverty very soon. Remain there. Remain there. Don't leave. There are some friendships you need to sacrifice. If not, you cannot fare well in life. That's what we call unprofitable association. Association that is not adding to you but taking from you. You are in big trouble. Now, how many of us know that there are plenty of opportunities in this Lafia? How many of us know? Some are saying, no, only government. Which government work? I reserve that for another day. Everyone I see here now has the capacity to enter into mega fortune. Though thy beginning be small, thy latter end shall greatly increase. If you can give yourself to learning, get committed to it, apply the law of delay gratification because you are not doing competition with anybody, you will arrive at where God has in mind for you. Scripture said, for I alone know the plan that I think towards you. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. To give you a future, a hope, and an expected end. You are not at your end yet. I want you to hear this. Your level can change. But you must be willing and committed to paying the price. If you pay the price great men pay, you will reach where great men reach. You will reach it. You will reach it. You will reach it. I said you will reach it. This same Lord is good unto all and richly bless all that calls upon his name. God does not have any special favorites. The same way he's thinking of how your levels can change, that's the same way he's thinking of how somebody else also level can also do what? Change. But until you do your part, God will not do his part. Rise up to your feet. Thank you. Misfortune is a choice. All you just need to do, hang around non-entities. Hang around failures. Hang around complainers. Hang around people that are telling you, Lafia is hard. Nigeria is tough. This Buhari, eh? Change. All this evil. Ah! Your destiny is not in the hand of Buhari. Your destiny is not in the hand of any government. You are absolutely responsible for the outcome of your life. If Papa can tell us, we pastors, I can't pay you. Shebi, you have heard it. It's God that will pay you. So you better look for your pay. Scripture says, work out your salvation. Salvation doesn't only mean free from sin or healed from sickness. Salvation includes prosperity. Work out your salvation with what? Fear and what? Trembling. You must work it out. And working it out demands paying your own price. If you want to be great financially, hear me, it's time to pay your price. You must pay your price. Any wealth you get suddenly, you will lose it suddenly. No wonder scripture says, he gotten wealth shall suddenly what? Diminish. But he that gathereth little by little shall surely do what? Increase. If you must gather, start paying your price. There is no magic anywhere. You have obeyed the law of tithing giving, then for favor to answer for you, start doing these things. Start. 2 Sundays ago, I was talking about a megad called Hassan. Started by selling sweet chewing gum, Omo. Before I graduated from university, he has fleets of shops. I said, heaven will not forgive me if I arrive heaven a poor man. For someone that is not in the covenant, it worked for him. You don't have any excuse. I don't have any excuse. How many are preparing to enter a boy's quarter when they get to heaven? You see, now nobody wants to raise his hand. You are going to lift up your voice and pray. Scripture says, a little sleep, a little slumber. He said, and poverty shall knock on your door. Scripture says, do not be slothful in business. To be slothful is to be lazy. To be slothful is to be complacent. To be slothful is to be lukewarm. To be slothful is to be procrastinating. I go. I bind that I go spirit in your life. I go. When will you? I go. That's procrastination. Jesus said, I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day. For the night cometh when no man can do what? Work. The greatest energy you need, momentum you need, is start. Start. Don't fear failure. Failure is just an experience. It's not an identity. If you fail, you learn. You learn one way not to fail again. We are going to pray, Lord, I vow a vow against poverty. I vow a vow against lack. I vow a vow against financial mediocrity. In the name of Jesus, I am taking steps that will move me forward. Lift up your voice and pray from the depth of your heart. I refuse to remain on the same spot. I refuse to remain on the same spot. I refuse to be on the same spot. I am making a change for my next level. Thank you, Father. All eyes closed, all heads bowed. Your journey is still very far if you are not born again. Scripture says, if a man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things have passed away. And all things have become what? New. You want to make it right with Jesus? That is the biggest opportunity, biggest decision anyone can ever make. Wherever you are, inside and outside, you want Jesus to be your Lord, that will guarantee you a lifetime of success. Put your right hand on your chest and say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come unto you today. I know that I'm a sinner. Forgive me. Wash me with your precious blood. I reject sin. I reject Satan. Come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. You pray that prayer with me wherever you are. Come for right now. I want to pray with you. Very quickly. Put your hands together for Jesus. If you're coming, come quickly. Put those hands together for the Lord. Put those hands together for Jesus. Come. Let me bring them from outside.
Jesus, the more I know you, the more I want to know.
Put those hands together for Jesus.
Jesus,
put those hands together for Jesus. Help me bring them.
Help me bring them.
Jesus, unto them that come unto you, shall you in no wise cast out. They've accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and as their Savior. I stand as your servant decreeing today that the guilt of their past, they are rolled away. Every curse, every accusation of the wicked, I speak for by the blood of Jesus, they are blotted out in the name of Jesus Christ. Any legal hold the enemy had over you before now, I speak forth by fire and by the blood, that hold is shattered. From today, the good hand of God rests permanently upon your life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are blessed. Congratulations. Put your hands together for Jesus for them. Just follow this man right now.